The three major performing rights organizations always host number one parties for their writers when their songs hit the top spot on the charts. However, it's not too often that each organization represents a writer on a number one song. Kelly Lynn headed over to a celebration at Nashville's Cabana for Sara Evans' hit, A Little Bit Stronger, which was hosted by BMI, ASCAP, and SESAC.
I'm here with Sara Evans today. It is a big day celebrating a number one. How are you?
I'm great. How are you?
I am good. Now, you just jet-setted right in from L.A., right?
Yes, we literally landed 2 hours ago from L.A. I sang a little bit stronger on Dancing with the Stars last night, the finale.
Oh, wow.
I know. It was so fun.
How fun. And now here you are today to celebrate a number one. I know this must be exciting because it's been a little while. You made an album and you moved, you got married, mm-hmm. You've done a lot of things. And now here you are, first single off the record, number one.
I mean, really, I'm just overwhelmed. I cannot believe it. I took some time, you know, for family and personal stuff and just to relax and enjoy, you know, being married to Jay and settling down in Birmingham and spent a lot of time making this album and, you know, hope that it would do this. I mean, everybody wants their first single off their album to rise to number one on the charts, but I really didn't expect it. I didn't, you know, I just can't believe that it, and then it stayed there for 2 weeks, and I'm just so grateful to have been, you know, given this song, and Hillary Scott, Hillary Lindsay, Luke Laird wrote it and did such a great job with both the lyrics and the melody and just the overall feel of the song. It's just a great song, and it's a song that everybody can relate to.
It doesn't happen overnight, but you turn around and a month's gone by.
Would you say it sort of went along with your life, too, that you'd fallen in love and fresh start, everything was just stronger, everything was better,
or well, I think,
was it something?
I think it's, you know, I think that's why the song has become so popular, because everybody feels that way. No, like last night, for instance, when I sang it on Dancing with the Stars, they related it to the dancers, the contestants, and how they started out not knowing how to dance, crying, you know, having it be so hard, and then getting stronger and stronger and stronger every single week, and then making it to the finale. So it's definitely a song that, you know, everybody's been through something hard in their life.
Absolutely.
Everybody, you know, has to come out on the other side of something hard, and so you're always stronger for it.
Get along without you, baby. I'm better off without you, baby. How does it feel without me, baby?
I'm here with the songwriters who wrote this big hit for Sara. We've got Hillary Scott, Hillary Lindsay, and Luke Laird. How are y'all doing?
Great.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
So when you all sat down, who came up with the idea? Did you have it before it all started, or?
Yeah. Well, I had just gotten out of a really awful relationship.
It was great timing.
It was really good timing, and we had actually, I think, scheduled and rescheduled this writing appointment a couple of times, and it obviously was for a reason, because I walk in there and I'm like, okay, I'm probably gonna cry, and I might as well tell you why at some point in this evening, because this is all really fresh and tough, you know. And so I had written a note in my phone that had said, because this relationship, he was calling all the time, he was texting me all the time, he was emailing me all the time, and I was just like, okay, I just need some space, like, leave me. And so finally it just was to the point where I was like, I can't respond. Not going to respond in any way, shape, or form. And every day that passed, as I would continue to not respond, I felt stronger. I felt like I was breathing better. I was like back to normal. And that was what I'd written in my phone. It's like every day apart, every day away from you, every day not answering your call, I get stronger.
Just a little bit.
Just fell out once she started talking about it, you know, the three of us, because God knows I've gone through it too many times. I mean, all of us have gone through it.
Yeah, life. So, even if it's not a relationship,
even if it's not, yeah.
Other things we have to go through.
Absolutely. So it was just so real and so honest, and, you know, having it be Hillary's story, and it made it even more real, you know, because she was so in the moment of it. Oh. So it was great.
How exciting. And for you, I mean, we all know that you're Lady A. You are with Lady A, you and two other guys, two other great guys. She's the lady in Lady A. So it must be double. I mean, that's pretty cool. Is this your first number one as a writer?
Yes. This was my first outside cut as a writer, and this is my first number one as
a
writer.
Your first outside
yeah.
cut.
Mm-hmm. So
that's awesome.
It's huge. I'm so excited, and it's a different sense of pride than you know, success that we've had as a band. Like, I'll never forget watching Sara perform on the ACMs. We were in like the second or third row and right in the center, and that she performed like this amazing performance, like dead center on the stage. And we were just like, I was just smiling at her, so goofy, and she was just nailing it, and she had a standing ovation. And I mean, that was just such a cool moment, and for it to have been recorded by someone who has been such a huge influence on me. I mean, I've been a fan of hers since the very beginning, you know, and to have her voice on it and her story coming out in every line as she sings it, I mean, it was really, really cool.
Awesome. Yeah. That's great. Congratulations. Congratulations, Luke. And you're no stranger to number ones, and Hillary, definitely, none of you. So you guys enjoy your party today, and congrats.
Thank you.
Woke up late today, and I still feel the sting of the pain, but I brush my teeth anyway. I got dressed, threw the mess, and put a smile on my face. I got a little bit stronger.
Claim is falling. We have only been working together less than 2 years, and I was in the process of making this album when I went to meet with him, and I sat in his office, and I was kind of scared. And he said to me, "You act like you're scared." And I said, "I am scared, because I've taken some time off, and my album's not finished, and time is clicking away, and I'm wondering if everybody in Nashville and everybody at country radio has forgotten about me and moved on." And he assured me that that was not the case, and he said to me, "I'm an acquired taste. I just want you to know that. I'm an acquired taste, and so if you're going to work with me, you need to know that." And he was so right. He may be an acquired taste, but he is an amazing manager. Clarence and Mark Jones, thank you both so much for helping me get back on my feet. And I love you both. It's been a pleasure working with you.
A Little Bit Stronger marks Sara's reemergence onto the country music scene. After all the personal issues she's had to deal with through the last few years, it seems she's back on track and is indeed a little bit stronger for it. We have to take another quick break, but we've got lots more ahead here on Inside Music Row. We'll head over to the Ryman Auditorium next, so don't go away. Make sure to come right back.
Hi, this is Mandy Burnett, and I'm coming up next on Inside Music Row.